the last few years, we have witnessed a growing impact of misinformation and disinformation in our democracies. And this has led us to build post-truth societies. That's why we think that it is particularly important to invest in education in order to counter this tendency. In fact, especially during the COVID-19 pandemic, when we have witnessed a real infodemic, we have noticed that in particular younger generations are exposed to this kind of phenomenon. We want to highlight the importance of having better education, both in terms of citizenship education and media literacy, to make young people recognize and react to misinformation and disinformation. The European Union has taken a particularly proactive role, especially in the last few years, in countering misinformation and disinformation, and in particular to promote education programs that can make younger citizens aware of these threats. In particular, in 2022, the European Union has produced some guidelines which are aimed to make the school curricula within the European Union better prepared to educate younger citizens. Unfortunately, we're living in a very diverse educational landscape in Europe, and that's why it is even more important that the European Union takes a stronger coordination role to make the education systems in national member states better prepared to face these threats. There is an issue connected to the need to make the platforms created by the European Union to counter misinformation and disinformation more visible and also used by teachers and by school systems all around Europe. That's why with the Reclaim project, we want to liaise with the schools in key member states to make them aware of the existence of these platforms and programs, and also to better integrate the education for citizens to counter misinformation and disinformation in their curricula. Social media platforms played a great role in spreading misinformation and disinformation, especially in the last few years. We have witnessed it during the COVID-19 pandemic, but also during the Ukrainian war following the Russian aggression. And we noticed that younger generations are particularly exposed to this misinformation and disinformation spread through the social platforms. At the same time, we know that social platforms can also help us, if used correctly, to counter post-truth information and misinformation and disinformation. And that's why we want to ensure that at the school level, children are educated to recognize these threats, but also to use the social platforms in the correct way, in order to help the whole society to be more resilient to these kind of threats.